Hello and welcome to the new series of Drishti IAS. I am Pooja Dwivedi, and in this segment today we are going to talk about the rift between the Gulf Cooperation Council members may come to an end after a long period of 3 years. This topic is important from the perspective of prelims as well as from the perspective of GS Mains Paper 1 and 2. Let's begin with the topics of discussions that we are going to look at. First of all, we will talk about Y News, which will be followed by the Gulf Cooperation Council. But before that, we will also talk about the background of the entire rift, what went wrong. Then we will talk about India's relation with the Gulf Cooperation Council, the challenges for India in the contemporary times, the way forward. And in the midst of the segment, I am going to ask you a prelims-based question. Comment the correct answer in the comment box. Let's begin with Y News, because India has welcomed fruitful discussions among the members of the Gulf Cooperation Council who are striving to tone down the long-drawn 3 years rift amongst them. So, before that, first of all, let's talk about the background, what happened exactly. In the year 2017, the United Arab Emirates, Bahrain, as well as Saudi Arabia cut their ties with Qatar. And what was the justification for it by the Saudi Arabian or the others or the other members was that Qatar is giving assistance to extremism in the neighboring region as well as Iranian militias. So there were certain countries that were in support of Qatar, such as Oman. After Saudi Arabia cut its ties, Oman still continued to cooperate with Qatar as well as Iran. But what happened because of that? Because of that, Qatar started feeling cornered, and after that, Qatar's foreign policy became more independent. Like any other cooperation or any other regional integration, Gulf Cooperation Council had its own shares of splits and differences among border demarcation, and if we talk about energy exploration, there were many rifts. In the year 2014, a similar rift was there with similar countries at the ends. Qatar on the one side, Bahrain, UAE and Saudi Arabia on the other side. So, but back then it only lasted for 9 months. Why? Because it did not spiral down. Because Kuwait, as of now, Kuwait is still playing the same part it played in the year 2014, when Kuwait and other non-aligned members also started mediating successfully. But as of now, Kuwait also failed to do any sort of mediation as well as the USA. But recently, the ambassador to Washington from the Gulf Cooperation Council and the other countries have said that we are trying to tone down our differences and there are seeds of progress as well. So this was in short. Alright, let's look at the map of Gulf Cooperation Council. Saudi Arabia is a member of it with its capital at Riyadh. Kuwait with its capital at Kuwait, Qatar with its capital at Doha, Bahrain with its capital at Manama, UAE with its capital at Abu Dhabi, and Oman with its capital at Muscat. So these are the members of the Gulf Cooperation Council. Right? Let's look at the Gulf Cooperation Council's features. So if we talk about it, this was established by an agreement which was concluded in the year 1981 amongst Bahrain, Kuwait, Oman, Qatar, Saudi Arabia and UAE. As any other regional integration, the prerequisites were checked, such as geographical proximity and similar political system based on similar Islamic beliefs, joint destiny, special relation amongst the members, like any other regional cooperation. So, if we talk about the structure of the Gulf Cooperation Council, it consists of the Supreme Council, which is the highest authority, and also the Ministerial Council and the Secretariat General. So, if we talk about the Secretariat, it's located at Riyadh, the capital of Saudi Arabia. And it's a political, economic, social and regional organization as well. If you talk about the aim, very simple, like any other regional cooperation, it wants to achieve coordination, integration, as well as deepen and intensify ties among the Gulf Cooperation Council and as a region to integrate and also create diplomatic channels with other countries as well, and also to enhance cooperation in the field of agriculture or in animal culture, as well as sea wealth, animal wealth, with scientific and technical progress in place, which will help all the members of the council. Now let's talk about the bonds of India and the Gulf Cooperation Council. Now, for India as well as the Gulf Cooperation Council, the most important aim for both of these regions is political stability as well as non-tension between the members. And if we talk about the trading values and economic cooperation, it cannot be emphasized enough. It is one of the largest trading blocks for India. So, now we will discuss the special features of India's relationship with the Gulf Cooperation Council. If we talk about the political arena, the governments of the Gulf Cooperation Council members are India-friendly as well as Indian-friendly. Prime Minister of India received the highest civilian order of the United Arab Emirates, that is the Order of Zayed. And if we talk about the third highest civilian order the Prime Minister received from the country Bahrain, was King Hamad Order of Renaissance, right? And if we talk about the recent past, Saudi Arabia and the UAE are not adopting any sort of hostile postures towards India, especially when it comes to the Kashmir policy, India's Kashmir policy. That's a good sign. Now, if we talk about the economic system, the Gulf Cooperation Council are among India's key supplier of energy, as well as annual remittances from India. And from these countries are worth rupees USD 4.8 billion. And there is a stronghold of Indian diaspora, approximately 8.5 million Indians who are skilled as well as unskilled live in these regions. And if we talk about these skilled and unskilled workers, of course, because of them, we are getting foreign remittances from this particular region. Now, Saudi Arabia is India's fourth largest trading partner, and respectively, and also total bilateral trade of the Gulf Cooperation Council, a Gulf Cooperation country with India, for the year 2018 and 19 stood at USD 121.34 billion. That's also, UAE features in the top 10 sources of foreign direct investment inflows in India. There has been an increase of investment from Saudi Arabia's end. As of August 2020, it was reported by the Economic Times that Saudi Arabia is going to invest approximately $15 billion in the Reliance Industries of India. And also, $60 billion in oil refinery in India. And of course, the dependence of India on Saudi Arabia cannot be underemphasized or emphasized enough. It is growing in volumes, the energy imports. And also, the Arab world finds it very attractive to invest in the hydrocarbon sector of India. So we have a lot of economic bonds together, but we need to look beyond it as well. So if we talk about security, both India and the Gulf Cooperation Council are the members of the Financial Action Task Force. And also, apart from the participation of Saudi Arabia, Oman, Kuwait, and these are the countries which participate in India's multilateral Milan exercise, India also has bilateral exercises with most of such countries. Let's look at them one by one. For example, India and Oman, these two countries, they hold bilateral exercises spanning all three sectors of the armed forces. If we talk about the army exercise, it's Al Najah, Air Force, it's Eastern Bridge, and naval exercise is Naseem Al Bahr. You have to remember, you have to note it down, that these are the exercises between India and Oman. And Oman has also provided or leveraged to the Indian Navy the port of Dakhm, Special Economic Zone. Now, this is one of the Indian Ocean's largest or deepest seaports. Okay, and India also has bilateral naval ties with UAE, like India or INUAE bilat and Air Force exercise Desert Eagle. Now, this is naval and that is Air Force. Right, moving on, let's talk about the recent developments. Saudi Arabia has been easing the kafala system. This system is something which exists in this region in which an employer acts as a guardian to the employee, and the employee is bounded to that particular, the migrant laborers basically, who work in the construction and the domestic industries. They are bounded to the particular employer for a very long period of time. So this particular system has been ended by Qatar as well. Now this will further translate to boosting of economic ties as well as closer people to people contact. And of course, if boosting of economic ties will be there, then foreign remittances will also increase. And also in the recent past, the Gulf Cooperation Council, many of the members of the Gulf Cooperation Council are not siding with Pakistan. And Saudi Arabia has in many instances endorsed the policy of India when it came to the Kashmir issue. And it has not endorsed the concept of Kashmir belonging to Pakistan on multilateral institutions as well. So it has made, Saudi Arabia has made it very clear where its priorities lie right now. Further, Saudi Arabia also ended the loan of Pakistan and any other associations with oil as well, when Islamabad time and again started repudiating the stand of Saudi Arabia on the Kashmir issue, right? So, the relationship of Pakistan and Saudi Arabia and some of the Gulf countries are going down. And if we talk about the challenges, right now the biggest challenge India is witnessing is the volatility in the Middle East. Middle East is a very volatile region right now, when Turkey is consistently rising up and also taking sides with Qatar. Turkey, as we know, is siding with Pakistan on the Kashmir issue. So this particular area is very volatile, and especially the Middle East, including Iran. If you remember the assassination of Jamal Khashoggi, as well as many other top officials of Iran. So this particular area is very volatile. India needs a balanced approach here. Also, conflict-infested region of the Gulf Cooperation Council. The members are not getting along of the Gulf Cooperation Council. Let's see what happens. This is also a part where India needs a very coordinated, and India needs to get an approach where it has to work on eggshells. Now, India is also working on a tightrope between West and the Gulf countries, in the sense that this particular region is already witnessing egregious violation of human rights. So recently, the US State Department has put Saudi Arabia on the list of countries of particular concern for violation of human rights. So this particular issue needs to be addressed, in the sense that India needs to have a balanced approach. Although Saudi Arabia's relationship with West is not bad at all, but it may, this particular thing, whatever the US State Department has done, this particular thing may affect the future of both the countries. Stagnant or dwindling trade. Now, since the last few years, the trade between India and the Gulf Cooperation Council is either not up to the mark as expected, or it's just stagnant. So if you can see the chart here, you can definitely see what is wrong. Right? Now let's talk about the way forward. The way forward is that the Gulf Cooperation Council has historical, political, economic, and strategic and cultural significance, of course, for India. So what does India need to do, and what does the GCC need to do? They need to strengthen the India-GCC Free Trade Agreement. And we should now look beyond the economic ties. We should also try to strengthen people-to-people contact. And also Indian government should try to tap the entire Indian diaspora that is working there, right? Now, if you talk about prelims-based question, you have to tell me in the comment segment, with which of the topmost three countries of the Gulf Cooperation Council, India has the largest trade? The top three you have to tell me, right? Okay, so presently the GCC region is very volatile, with Turkey also playing the part, and also US has very rising interest in the Middle Eastern sector. So right now it's very volatile. India needs to safeguard its large economic interest. In the sense, it should enhance cooperation in the field of technology, in the field of agriculture, in the field of water conservation. So these are the areas where the GCC and India can cooperate. And also, India as well as the GCC members should also enhance high ministerial visits to each other's region. So this is the way forward for right now, and India needs to tackle whatever is happening in the Middle East. India should also meander along with the, but not that much that it loses its ground. That's it for today. Tomorrow we shall meet again. Thank you so much for watching, and stay updated.